one of my older brothers, when I was 10 maybe, if that, he had just gotten his driver's license. And I helped him put an engine in one of these 63 Impalas, you know. Neither one of us really knew much what we were doing, but I was helping. You know, I was thoroughly enjoying that. And that was my start kind of in the really the car things. I like classic cars. I like restoring them, working on them. I probably actually like, if you get down to it, I like working on them, restoring them better than I do going to the shows. My wife always asks me, how can you spend 12 hours out there and work on those things all day? And I said, oh, man, the day just flew by. I didn't even know what happened. My name's Don Rogers, and I own two 64 Impalas. One is a convertible, and one is a hardtop. And a lot of people ask me, why do you have two of the same kind of car? When I was a kid, one of my first cars was a 64 Impala. Nothing near as nice as these, but it was the same kind of car. And everybody knows what they are, and they say, hey, I know where there's one of those cars at, or something, somebody will tell me. I know where there's probably three right now that I could go and buy that are in pretty rough shape. And that's how I end up sometimes with more. I mean, I've had more than two. I only have two right now. I've owned many more than that and had more at the same time. '64 hardtop that I own, when I got it, it was mostly all there as far as parts and pieces and drivetrain, but it was a rusty mess. The guy that owned the car, his health really got bad and worse and worse and worse, and the car just sat. And at one point, his brother told me they took the car and put it in the backyard so that he could see it out his bedroom window. And so it basically sat, he said it sat in the backyard for 10 years. And so it was pretty rusty when I got it. The history of the convertible is somebody called and told me about it, and it was in Annapolis, Maryland, and I got it in 2011, I guess, and it had been sitting in that garage since 1980. It hadn't been run. We had to drag it out of there and drag it on a trailer. It was in a little rougher shape, which is typical of a convertible. And I usually paint my cars a piece at a time instead of doing it all together, because you can do a much better job that way. Yeah, I do. I don't farm anything out. I do it all myself. I think I did that black car in about 10 months, I believe. I mean, the hardtop car. But that's working every day, all day. A lot of labor. Yeah, that's for sure. You know, I'd much rather drive around in a car that I completely built myself with my own two hands. Much more pride in it than if I just went down to the dealership and bought a brand new Camaro or a Mustang and I'm riding around in that. And yeah, that's all right, but everybody can do that. That's part of the fun, is taking it out and thrashing it. I don't worry about it if it gets hurt. I mean, my theory is, hey, I made it the first time, I can do it again. If I crash it or something falls off, well, just fix it. These cars have air ride suspension on them, and I've pulled up to a stoplight and guys start hollering out the window and whatever, and you take and hit that button and dump that car down right there, and they just freak out. I had one guy that I thought he was gonna fall out of the car. He was so excited. I mean, you couldn't take these cars out without somebody hollering, waving, beeping. It's just what they are. This convertible is back here behind us, 64 Impala convertible SS, and it has the interior in it is the color of a 59 Impala, which is back in the 50s, they did things a lot different. You can tell by the really bright colors in it and the speckled carpet and all that kind of stuff. And so I actually took a pattern from a 59 and put it into this car. And it just really jumps out at you. And I really like that when you have the top down, the sun hits it. Those cars are original, and that's the way they drove back in the day. I mean, they make all kinds of stuff now you can put in there to make them shift like a little Honda, you know, where it just goes click, 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 but that's not the way these cars were. You really gotta pull on that thing to shift gears, and that's what they were made to be. and it is nothing but fun to shift gears in that car and wind it out. In the 60s, you could go down a list. You could pick out what motor you wanted, what transmission you wanted, your windshield wipers. This particular hardtop has the engine that's a 300 horsepower 327, which was the standard engine in the Corvette in 1964. And so that's why it's got that rumpy, dumpy, lumpy sound. And it has the glass pack mufflers, which was a 60s kind of a thing that everybody did back in the day to make your car sound like that. You can go out and drive that car and take 20 years off your life and just cares go away and everything. And that's a little therapy thing there. These 264 Impalas for me I pretty much enjoy everything about them. All the notoriety you get from having them and the people hollering at you and giving you a thumbs up just makes you feel good. And that's what life's all about.